Hello everyone, welcome to Pharma Guide. Today we'll start the topic quality control of tablets. How quality control works in the industries to produce a quality product. Quality control of tablets. Quality control is part of GMP, by which quality control personnel analyzes the quality of all factors involved in production in order to eliminate errors at every stage in the production. Quality control mainly deals with the identification of defects or errors and eliminating them. Manufacturing, what is GMP? Manufacturing practices which result in good quality finished products and has adequate consideration for safety of employees is recognized as GMP. GMP is concerned with both production and quality control. Quality control is product oriented and focus on the defect identification. We discussed in previous video. Quality control is a set of activities for ensuring quality in the product, and it focuses on the identifying defects in the actual products produced. Following specifications must be determined prior to development of solid dosage forms. Quality control of raw materials, quality control of manufacturing procedures and equipments, granulation mix analysis, in-process controls, quality control of finished dosage form, and quality control of packaging and labeling. So quality control is done at every stage in the production. Okay, now quality control of raw material for solid dosage forms. Characterization of chemical and physical properties of drug substance, that is API and excipients, is one of the most important steps in development of solid dosage forms. Chemical properties, especially the identification of impurities, is very important, and they must be identified in visual inspection with color and odor. Physical properties of API and excipients such as solubility, polymorphism, hygroscopicity, particle size, density, etc. must be observed. Each raw material is sampled according to the standard sampling procedures and is sent to quality control laboratory for testing. If the raw material is acceptable, it is moved to the release area. Then it came in use or in the production. They should be able to provide data to demonstrate that dissolution profiles and content uniformity will be satisfactory over a wide range of particle size. Particle size is important because in addition to release or dissolution, variation in the particle size, particle shape or bulk density can have effect on uniformity of the dosage forms, particularly those manufactured by the direct compression or direct. Now, quality control checks during the manufacturing. For manufacturing of solid dosage form, detailed manufacturing directions specifying equipment and operating parameters must be specified. These are specified in batch manufacturing record. What if these operating parameters or quantities are not specified? Failure to specify the amount of granulating solution result in overwetting and dissolution failure of the aged batches. These are the examples. Failure to specify compression machine or operating parameters resulting in content uniformity failures. What are these parameters? Like temperature, time, particle size, texture, pressure, weight, hardness, thickness, diameter, disintegration, dissolution, friability, moisture content, or relative humidity. These are the parameters which must be specified in the batch manufacturing records. Okay, now quality control parameter for tablet granulation. Granulation may be defined as a size enlargement process which converts small particles into physically stronger and larger agglomerates. Granulation process can be classified into two types. Wet granulation, that involves the wet massing of the powder blend with granulating liquid, then wet sizing and drying. And dry granulation, where powder mixture is compressed to form the slugs, then sizing and compression. Quality control parameters for granulation are particle size and shape. The particle size of granulation affect the average solid dosage form weight, weight variation, disintegration time, granule friability, granulation flowability, and the drying rate kinetics of the wet granulation. Particle size profile are particularly important for the tablet made by wet granulation process. The size, even the type of granule, can affect the pore size of the tablet, which is important in disintegration and have an effect on dissolution also. Next is loss on drying and moisture content. If organic solvents are employed, Then residual solvent residues, these are also tested. In validation of the drying process, loss on drying labels are determined prior to, during and after drying in each order to demonstrate times and levels. As with processing variables, labels are established in the development phase with validation phase used to confirm the adequacy of the process. After validation, what should be the moisture content of the granules is specified. Loss on drying is calculated prior, during and after drying of the granules. This will indicate when to stop drying of the granules. If specified loss on drying is reached, then drying must be stopped. So this is followed in the during the manufacturing of the product. Okay, now disintegration test. Disintegration test of the granules is also done for checking disintegration quality of the product, and assay is also done. Now, a critical step in manufacture of solid dosage form is blending of the final granulation. If uniformity is not achieved at this stage, then one could assume that some dosage units will not comply with the uniformity requirements. Now, sampling is done after blending of the final granulation, and assay is also done to make sure the content uniformity. Sampling is important at every step in the manufacturing. Granulation is the act or process of forming or crystallizing into grains. Granules typically have a size between 0.2 to 4 mm depending on their subsequent use. Agglomeration or particle size enlargement process are also used to modify product properties. Agglomeration of the powder is widely used to improve the physical properties such as wettability, flowability, bulk density and product appearance. Now, quality check during the solid dosage form compression. Tablets are prepared by compression of powder blend or the granules. Compression machine is of two types, single punch and multi punch or multi station rotary press. The compression machine are designed with the following basic components: hopper for holding and feeding the granulation to be compressed, dies that defines the size and shape of the dosage form, punches for compression or compressing the granulation within the dies, Camtrex for guiding the movement of the punches, and feeding mechanism for moving granulation from hopper into the dies. These basic components of the machine must be checked during the solid dosage form compression. What are the factors that are to be considered during the compression? First is tooling. Shape, size and concavity of the tooling should be examined based on the formulation properties and commercial specifications. For the embossed tablets, factors such as position of the intaglations on the tablet, intaglation depth and style should be examined to ensure that picking of the intaglation during the compression or fill in the intaglation during the coating does not occur. Okay, like letter A is embossed on the tablet, then what is the style, what is the depth of the that letter? During coating, the picking and logo filling must not occur. We'll study all these things in detail later. This is the first factor which is to be considered during the compression: tooling, shape and size and concavity of the tooling. Next, compression speed. Formulation should be compressed at a wide range of compression speed to determine the operating range of the compressor. Now, during the validation, range of the compression speed is established. During the manufacturing, it is to be followed. Is a force feeder required to ensure that sufficient material is fed into the dies? It depends on the compression speed. If compression speed is high, then force feeder is required to ensure that sufficient material is fed into the dies. The speed of the machine can affect fill of the die and tablet weight. Speed of the machine affects the fill of the die and tablet weight, and it is important to have a specific operating directions. Next is compression or ejection force. The compression profile for the formulation will need to be determined to establish the optimum compression force to obtain the desired hardness of the product. Now, it is also validated. Compression force range is also established during the validation to produce tablet with the optimum hardness. Now, these quality checks are performed at every 15 minutes during the compression. What hardness, thickness, diameter, disintegration, weight variation, friability, these are conducted during the manufacturing. In case of coated tablet, the key areas to be considered are tablet properties, Equipment type, coater load, pen speed, spray gun and spray rate, volume of coating solution, rate and temperature, these must be controlled. After coating the quality parameters, quality control parameters are dissolution test, disintegration test, hardness test, weight uniformity, moisture content test. Number of application of the coats, volume of coating solution in a specific application and temperature of solution during application, these are also the important parameters that need to be addressed. For example, temperature of application and even heat during the drying have found to cause dissolution failures in the aged tablets. Another problem associated with the coating process concerns the heat applied to the products that are sensitive to heat. For example, it has been shown that estrogen tablets are heat sensitive and have exhibited stability problems. Thus, it is important to control this phase of process also. In-process quality control test. IPQC is concerned with providing accurate, specific and definite description of the procedures to be employed from raw material, receipt of the raw material to release of the finished dosage forms. IPQC means controlling procedure involved in manufacturing of the dosage forms, starting from the raw material purchase to the dispatch of the quality product in the ideal packaging. In-process testing enables easier identification of the problems. It sometimes identifies the defective product batch that can be corrected by the rework, whereas once the batch has been completed, this may not be possible. Failure to meet in-process control specifications indicates either that procedures were not followed or some factors were out of control. Now, IPQC for tablets. IPQC for tablet environmental control, filter condition, humidity and temperature monitoring. IPQC for materials, checking for the name, lot number, weight, particle size, bulk density, color, water content, balances and scales, sifter, granulator and multi-mill with scale. IPQC for tablet mixing and massing. Okay, mixing and massing means during the granulation also. Checking for proper equipment and addition of ingredients, mixing time, sampling from the top, middle and bottom. After mixing, sampling is very important. That will confirm the API is distributed completely in the powder blend. Checking for the binder temperature, rate and addition time, massing time, load reading, wet milling, speed, screen, equipment checking. These factors must be checked during the manufacturing to produce a quality product or product free from the defects. IPQC for tablet drying. Cleaning condition of an equipment and filter bags in the FBD, separate bags for each, loading uniformity, air temperature, outlet temperature, time for drying, moisture control and determination. Moisture control and determination is important because when the specific the loss on drying is reached, then drying of the granules is stopped. Proper sifting and control of oversized granules, fine collection and lubrication. Proper mixing of the specified product. These are the IPQC for tablet drying. Next, IPQC test for tablets. Weight variation of the tablet, hardness of the tablet, thickness, friability, uniformity of content, disintegration time, dissolution time, content of the active ingredients. IPQC test for the coated tablets. Moisture content of the dried granule, granulation, particle size distribution, blend uniformity, individual tablet weight, hardness, thickness, disintegration, impurity profile. IPQC problems in tablets, capping, lamination, picking, mottling, weight variation, poor flow, poor mixing, hardness, variation, double impression. We'll study all these things detail in the next coming video. Now, quality control of finished dosage forms. Compressed tablets may be characterized or described by a number of specifications. These include shape, diameter, thickness, weight, hardness, friability, disintegration time and dissolution characteristics. First of all, we'll study diameter and shape. The diameter and shape depends on the dies and punches selected for the compression of the tablet. Shape and size of the tablet depend on the dies and punches. Generally, tablets are described in shape, although they may also be oblong, oval, round, cylindrical, or triangular. The upper and the lower surface, it may be flat, also round, concave, or convex to the various degrees. Top and lower surface may be embossed or engraved with a symbol or letter, which serve as an additional mean of identifying the source of the tablets. It is the identification, it may also be then identification of the tablets. These characteristics along with the color of the tablet tend to make them distinctive and identifiable with the active ingredient which they contain. Vernier caliper is used to measure the diameter of the tablets. Now, tablet thickness. Thickness of the tablet is the only dimensional variable related to the compression process. Tablet thickness is consistent from batch to batch or within a batch only if the tablet granulation or powder blend is adequately consistent in particle size and size distribution, if the punch tooling is of consistent length, and if the tablet press is clean and in good working order. The thickness of the individual tablet may be measured with a micrometer. Micrometer is used to measure the tablet thickness. Thickness should be controlled within plus minus 5% variation of a standard value. Thickness must be controlled for the consumer acceptance of the product and to facilitate the packaging. Micrometer is used to measure the thickness of the tablet. Organoleptic properties, color, odor and taste. Many pharmaceutical tablets use color as a vital means of rapid identification and consumer acceptance. The color of a product must be uniform within a tablet also. Non-uniformity of the coloring not only lacks the aesthetic appeal but could be associated with poor quality of the product. Odor. The presence of odor in a batch of tablets could indicate stability problems, such as odor of the acetic acid in degrading aspirin tablets. However, the presence of odor could be characteristic for the drugs like vitamins, added ingredients, flavoring agents, or the dosage form, film-coated tablets. Taste is important in consumer acceptance of especially quality control parameters for the solid dosage form packaging and labeling. Pharmaceutical manufacturers have to pack and put required labeling to their medicines before they can be sent out for the distribution. Every pharmaceutical preparation must comply with the labeling requirement established under the good manufacturing practices. The label should include name of the pharmaceutical product, name of the active ingredients, and INNs, international non-proprietary names, should be used wherever possible. Amount of active ingredients in each dosage unit and number of dosage unit in the container, batch or lot number assigned by the manufacturer, expiry date, date of manufacturing, any special storage conditions or handling precautions that may be necessary, direction for use, warnings, precautions that may be necessary, name and address of the manufacturer or the person responsible for placing the product in the market. Tablets should be able to withstand handling, including the packaging and transportation, without losing their integrity. Moisture-sensitive forms such as effervescent tablets should be stored in a tightly closed containers or moisture-proof packs and may require the use of separate packaging packages containing water-absorbent agents. Okay, in my next video, we will study the quality control test in detail, weight variation, disintegration, dissolution, drug content, hardness, friability with the procedures. Please watch my next video also, and if you like content of this video, please like and subscribe to my channel Pharma Guide.